So in this class, we are going to see details of abdominal aorta with its ventral branches. So the aorta, as we know, it is arising from the upper border of heart as arch of aorta. Then after it is descending posterior in the thoracic cavity as descending thoracic aorta. Later it is going to pass through the aortic opening of diaphragm, which is a muscular partition seen between the thoracic cavity and the abdominal cavity. And in that thoracic, in this diaphragm part, we will be having an opening called aortic opening. So through that opening, we will be having this entrance of descending aorta, which is reaching the abdominal part. So we are calling that as abdominal aorta. So this abdominal aorta, it will reach in the lower part, that is at the level of L4 vertebra. So the extent, if you are taking the abdominal aorta, it is extending from T12 vertebral level to the L4 vertebral level, where it will divide into two branches. So those two branches are called as terminal branches, which we will call as left common iliac artery, and then we will be having right common iliac artery. And this abdominal aorta, on the whole, the vertical course will be around 10 to 12 centimeter in its length. And now we are going to deal only about the details of three important branches which are arising from the ventral aspect of abdominal aorta. So to deal with the details, so see, now we are going to focus the major arteries coming from the anterior aspect of abdominal aorta. So as we know, this is the abdominal aorta. Here, the ventrally, we have three branches arising. One we will call as celiac trunk. So this artery is called as celiac trunk. Then after, we will be having next artery. Just below that, we will call as superior mesenteric artery. Celiac trunk will be at the level of L2. As soon as the abdominal aorta is descending below the diaphragm, we will be having the origin of this celiac trunk. One level below, that is one vertebral level below, at the L1 level, we will be having the origin of superior mesenteric artery. Later, at the level of L3 vertebral level, we will be having another artery arising. We will call that as inferior mesenteric artery. So these are the three important branches which are arising from the anterior aspect of abdominal aorta. So now we will see details of each artery separately. Talking about celiac trunk, so as we can make out, it is just a small part, you can see. So it is just about 1.25 centimeter in length. Later it will divide into three important branches. One is going towards the left side, which is tortuous in its course. We will call that as splenic artery, as this will end up in spleen. So we are calling this as splenic artery. Later we will be having another artery, which is a first artery to arise from celiac trunk. We will call as left gastric artery. This is also winding and going towards the left side. So celiac trunk, it is giving two branches towards the left side. One is splenic artery and another one is left gastric artery. On the right side, we will be having one artery arising from the celiac trunk. We will call that as common hepatic artery. So these are the three important branches coming out from the celiac trunk, and about the branches of these things we will deal later. Now we will move on to superior mesenteric artery. This superior mesenteric artery, again, it will be having a long course, and in this course it will be having a concavity towards the right side and convexity towards the left side. We can make out that. So this is the concavity of the superior mesenteric artery, and this is the convexity towards the left side. And from the convex part of the superior mesenteric artery, we will be having many jejunal and ileal branches arising. You can make out many branches, small branches which are arising from the convex side. We will be calling that as jejunal and ileal branches below. So these are the jejunal and ileal branches of superior mesenteric artery, which are arising from the left margin of the superior mesenteric artery, which will be 12 to 15 in number. Now if we see this right margin, which is concave, here we will be having three important branches arising. So we will be having first branch called as inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery. So we will be having first branches inferior pancreaticoduodenal, and below that we will be having middle colic artery, and then below that we will be having right colic artery, and below one we will call as ileocolic artery. So on the right side we will be having four branches. One is inferior pancreaticoduodenal, then we will be having middle colic, and then we will be having right colic, and later ileocolic artery. So these will anastomose with each other by means ascending and descending branches, which I will explain you in a diagrammatic representation. After celiac trunk and superior mesenteric, we have one more artery which is arising from the ventral aspect. We will call that as inferior mesenteric artery. This inferior mesenteric artery, it is giving branches such as we will be having left colic artery, and then we will be having some sigmoid branches, and later we will be having superior rectal artery, which is a continuation of inferior mesenteric artery, which will go downwards. So these are the major arteries which are arising from the ventral aspect of abdominal aorta. Now we will deal about each artery separately with its branches and how it's getting anastomosis with other branches and getting supply or giving supply to organs present in the abdominal part, and how it is going to supply forming the anastomotic, any specific pattern of its anastomosis, all those details we will deal now. So in today's topic we are going to deal with an artery, the major vessel seen in the abdominal region, that is abdominal aorta. So while explaining an artery, we have got some important things to deal with, such as from where it is taking its origin, and second thing, where it is getting terminated or getting ended up. So origin and termination we are going to see. Along with that, those arteries which are passing to the particular region will be giving some important branches and where these branches are getting supply. So these things are the major parts we are going to get in explanation of an artery. So in today's topic we are going to deal with abdominal aorta. Aorta, as you already know, it is an important vessel in our human body, which is having its origin in the thoracic region, and then it is extending downwards in the abdominal part, and in the abdominal part, the part of aorta we are calling as abdominal aorta, and in the pelvic, just above the pelvic region, it is going to terminate by dividing into two important branches. So first we will get to see the origin of the abdominal aorta. So the origin, it is nothing but a continuation of descending thoracic aorta. So as you know already, we have got a muscle in the middle part between the thorax and abdominal region. So imagine we have got a muscular region in the body which is dividing the thoracic cavity above. So we have got above thorax and below abdomen, and those two are divided by means of a muscular partition, and this muscular partition is nothing but diaphragm. So this is the diaphragm part which is dividing the two cavities of our body, that is thoracic cavity and the abdominal cavity. And the artery which we are dealing as aorta, which is having its origin in the thoracic cavity, such as we have got heart present in the thoracic cavity, and from the heart we have got an important artery arising, that is aorta. And this aorta in thoracic region has divided into ascending arch of aorta and descending thoracic aorta. So three parts of aorta are divided in the thoracic region. Then after, by piercing the diaphragm, the muscle, it is getting entered in the abdomen part. So after piercing the diaphragm, it is called in the abdominal region as abdominal aorta. So this is the artery which we are going to deal now. So this whole artery we are calling as abdominal aorta. So this is descending thoracic aorta which is present in the thorax, and this is ascending thoracic aorta, and this is arch of aorta. So about these things we will deal in the thoracic region. Now we are concerned about abdominal aorta, which is seen in the abdominal region. So origin, you know, it is a continuation of descending thoracic aorta. So this descending thoracic aorta, piercing the diaphragm, going to get continued as abdominal aorta.
and termination, this abdominal aorta is getting divided into two important branches on the right and left side, and these two branches are named as iliac artery. So near to the ilium bone it is getting divided, so it is called as iliac artery. So we are calling this as again right iliac artery and left iliac artery. So this is left iliac artery and this one is right iliac artery. So this is the termination of this abdominal aorta. So origin and termination, I think people are clear. Descending thoracic aorta continuing as abdominal aorta, which is terminating by dividing into two important branches, right and left iliac artery. Now we are going to deal about the extent of this particular aorta. Extent in the sense from where it is starting and what are the surface landmarks related to it to understand a better way of where it is found. So extent, if you are seeing, it is present opposite, that is the starting point here. The starting and ending we are going to see for the extent of abdominal aorta, and it is first in the origin point, it is seen opposite the lower border of T12 vertebra. So you know we have got posterior aspect with vertebras. So we have got 7 cervical vertebra, 12 thoracic vertebra, 5 lumbar vertebra and 1 sacral vertebra, which is having 5 sacral vertebra fused together, and then we have got coccygeal vertebra. Now we have got T12 thoracic vertebra seen in the abdominal region till the L4 vertebra. So we have got this as an extent. So the extent of this descending thoracic aorta, abdominal aorta is starting from lower border of T12 thoracic vertebra. So from here it will be having its extent starting, and then it is getting extended till the body of L4 lumbar vertebra. So this is thoracic vertebra's last vertebra, and we have got remaining vertebras present where all this are getting related, that such as L1 and L2 and L3. And it is extending the artery, which we are talking as abdominal aorta, extending from lower border of T12 thoracic vertebra to the L4 vertebras opposite the body of it. So this is considered as extent of the abdominal aorta. I think it is clear. So behind this abdominal aorta, we have got the back region where we have got vertebral column, and these are the vertebras where it is getting related. Now talking about the length of this abdominal aorta, the length is extending from L12 to L4 vertebra, which will be around 10 to 11 centimeter. So length to 11 centimeter will be the length, and if you are talking about the breadth, it will be 2 centimeter. So breadth of the artery is 2 centimeter, length is 10 to 11 centimeter. So that's all about the general concept of abdominal aorta. Now we will get to see what are the structures, other structures related to this abdominal aorta, such as front, behind and on the right and left side of this particular artery.